Hello and welcome back to our channel and to the O-RAN series. After having looked at the introduction, timelines and releases, architecture, TSC and workgroups and workgroup 1, in this video we will look at workgroup 2 and 3 in some more detail. Just a quick note here, it's been a while since we discussed the various O-RAN workgroups. If you haven't seen our video on that one, or just need a quick refresher, check it out, link on the top right corner. In the last video in this series, we looked at Workgroup 1 in detail. If you haven't seen it, then please do check it out as well, link on the top right corner. As we have discussed earlier, Workgroup 2 or WG2 deals with non-real-time RIC and the A1 interface. Its activities fall within three main streams: use cases and requirements, A1 interface and specifications, and AI/ML technical report. The primary goal of non-RT RIC is to support non-real-time intelligent radio resource management, higher layer procedure optimization, policy optimization in RAN, and providing AI/ML models to near-RT RIC and other RAN functions. The A1 interface supports communication and information exchange between non-RT RIC and near-RT RIC. The key objective is to support policy-based guidance of near-RT RIC functions and use cases, transmission of enrichment information in support of AI/ML models into near-RT RIC, and basic feedback mechanisms from near-RT RIC. Let us start by looking at specifications and reports approved by WG2. The first one is non-RT RIC and A1 interface. Use cases and requirements technical specification. This document describes the RAN optimization and control related initial use cases that have been approved within O-RAN Workgroup 2. The purpose of these use cases is to help identify requirements for O-RAN defined interfaces and functions, specifically non-RT RIC function and A1 interface, eventually leading to formal drafting of interface specifications. For each use case identified, this document describes the motivation, resources, steps involved, and data requirements. Finally, the requirements section details the functional and non-functional requirements derived from these use cases. Then there are four technical specifications looking at the A1 interface. They are general aspects and principles, transport protocol, application protocol, and type definitions. The general aspect and principles document specifies the general aspects and principles of the A1 interface. This document, as the name says, specifies the application protocol of the A1 interface. An important point to note with this particular specification is that if the version numbers are different for the near-RT and non-RT RIC, there may be implications for the compatibility. An incremented first digit of this specification could indicate that a new major feature, for example, new A1 service, has been added, or that an incompatible change has been made to an A1 service. An incremented second digit could indicate that an optional feature has been added, or that clarifications or corrections have been made. The compatibility of A1 implementations in non and near RT RIC depends on which A1 services have been implemented and which versions of A1 service have been implemented. The version of an A1 service is indicated by the API version in the URI, and compatibility is governed by the version of the Open API document for the A1 service. This document handles the service compatibility aspects, while A1 interface type definitions, which we will look in a minute, handles the compatibility for data types used by the A1 services. This document specifies the transport protocol of the A1 interface. This is the final of the four technical specifications looking at the A1 interface. This document specifies the data model and the data types that are used in the body of the procedures in the A1 interface. Chapter 5 of this document describes policy type compatibility, while Chapter 7 describes EI type compatibility. For compatibility of A1 implementations in non-RT and near-RT rigs, it must be ensured that all implemented policy and EI types are compatible with each other. This technical report addresses the overall architecture and solution for AI/ML related requirements for the use cases described in the WG2 use cases and requirements document. The document provides the terminology, workflow, and requirements related to AI/ML model training and its distribution and deployment in the radio access network. This technical report provides the overall functional architecture of the non-RT rig. It is a collection of concepts and requirements that are intended to be used in the subsequent specification of the non-RT rig architecture. It is not intended to define normative requirements for the conformance of implementations. This is a new document that was released for the first time in July this year. This technical specification for the non-RT rig architecture consists of collection of requirements on the non-RT rig framework, hosted applications, and services of the R1 interface. This document specifies the non-RT rig framework functionalities and services exposed to the applications. So these were the approved specifications and reports by O-RAN Alliance Workgroup 2 that are publicly available. Let us now move to Workgroup 3. As we have discussed earlier, WG3 deals with the near real-time rig and the E2 interface. Its main activities are to specify the near-RT rig open architecture and its functionalities, the radio network information base and network topology, and modular onboarding of new control applications. In addition, WG3 is responsible for specifying the E2 interface between the near-RT rig and the CUDU stack. Finally, WG3 oversees interaction with WG2, WG5, and WG6 to drive aspects related to near-RT rig. Let us start looking at specifications and reports approved by WG3. The Workgroup 3 use cases and requirements technical specification describes the initial use cases that have been approved within O-RAN WG3. The purpose of these use cases is to help identify requirements for O-RAN defined interfaces and functions, specifically near-RT rig functions and into interface, eventually leading to formal drafting of interface specifications. For each use case, this document describes the motivation, resources, steps involved, and data requirements. Finally, the requirements section within the document details the functional and non-functional requirements derived from these use cases. The near-RT rig architecture and E2 general aspects and principles technical specification describes the overall architecture of the near-RT rig and the general aspects and principles of the E2 interface, including the interaction with applications hosted in the near-RT rig. The near-RT rig E2 application protocol technical specification specifies the near-RT rig layer signaling protocol for the E2 interface. As we have discussed in earlier videos, the E2 interface provides means for interconnecting a near-RT rig and an E2 node. The E2 application protocol, or E2AP, supports the functions of E2 interface by signaling procedures defined in this document. E2AP is developed in accordance with general principles stated in O-RAN E2 General Aspects and Principles specifications. Then we have four documents for E2 service model. Let's start looking at each of them. The E2 services model technical specification describes the O-RAN specified RAN function specific service models supported over E2 and presents a recommended layout for additional E2 SM specifications. The RAN function network interface is used to provide RIC specific expose of the network interface logical function of the E2 node. This technical specification specifies the E2 service model network interface for the RAN function handling the network interfaces in an E2 node. This technical specification specifies the E2 service model key performance measurement for the RAN function handling reporting of the cell level performance measurement for the 5G networks as well as for the EPC networks and their possible adaptation of UE level and QoS flow level measurements. This technical specification specifies the E2 service model for the near RT-RIC RAN control interaction. Each E2 node terminating the E2 interface is assumed to host one or more instances of the RAN function RAN control. The final document is near RT-RIC architecture technical specification. It specifies the overall architecture of the near RT-RIC and function descriptions, including the interaction between hosted applications and common functions in the near RT-RIC. Here is a summary of all O-RAN Alliance Workgroup 3 approved specifications and reports by O-RAN Alliance WG3 that are publicly available. So these were O-RAN Alliance Workgroups 2 and 3 in brief. In the next one, I am planning to cover Workgroups 4 and 5. As always, feel free to let us know what you think. If you liked it, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Thanks again for watching and see you again soon. Goodbye.